Hey guys, we are standing in the middle of a 500 acre block of timber in central Indiana, and we are down here looking at opportunities and places for fall food plot plantings. You know, oftentimes you'll drive through a piece of timber and drive right by a piece of open ground like this and not even give it a second thought. We are working with the hand that we were dealt on this property, and there are very few, if any, openings bigger than this. This may be a fifth of an acre. It's a triangular shaped piece of a wedge of an old logging deck. As you can see, there's maybe 8 or 10 3-inch sapling trees growing up in here and some weeds and grasses. That's a great sign because it means sunlight is ample enough to grow this in here, which means it will grow a food plot for us. We have some choices though for a woodland food plot like this. Perennials are oftentimes hard to grow in a stand of timber like this, but definitely what you want to consider are fall planted cool season annuals. That includes your cereal grains, your annual clovers, your brassica family plants, because those plants are coming out of the ground and growing quickly as the temperatures are cooling down. So they put on a lot of growth, they're easy to grow, they don't take a lot of care, they're inexpensive, and they're incredibly attractive to the deer. So with very minimal tools, we're gonna take a chainsaw and cut these trees off. We're gonna take a sprayer. After we mow these weeds down, we're gonna spray Roundup or glyphosate and burn this area down and kill it. And we're gonna come back here in about 3 to 4 weeks and we're gonna put some generalized fertilizer and some basic lime and work it up in the ground and put our fall food plot in. And we're gonna follow up and show you what this thing can look like with just very minimal tools and very little effort. Okay, here we are. We're on the final stages of creating these fall food plots in this big timber project that we started back in June. It's really fun and interesting and exciting because this is a new property to us. We've established 6 micro plots in the timber that were once log decks that have been out of commission for years. And what we did is came back here in June with chainsaws and a mower and cleared these things where we could actually cut them down short. We took an ATV tank sprayer. We sprayed them with glyphosate and burned down the weeds and grasses. We came back a second time and we put down lime and fertilizer based on soil testing. But one thing that we assessed here after we got everything cleared and burned down and prepared was that we had years and years of layers of dead leaves and weeds and thatch laying on top of the soil. And we really didn't notice that until we came back after the burn down. We could see that. So the last thing in the world we want to do is apply seed on top of an inch layer of dead material, because seed to soil contact is so very critical. We used a couple different methods. Luckily, we had the ability to use the Furminator and a nice tractor to disc it up to expose soil. But there's several different ways you guys could do it with even simpler hand tools. A couple guys in large leaf rakes could have raked this off in an hour. Using fire is a good method as long as you're trained and understand how to do that safely. A rake behind an ATV, like a leaf rake, a lawn or a rock rake that people use for driveways is a good way to pull that off there. So here we are today, we're putting seed in the ground. And what we're doing is we're putting seed in the ground for the very first time, and we're expecting to provide attraction and nutrition right now for the fall. But we're also using a little strategy of using a perennial clover that we can put in the ground here in August with an accompanying seed, and we're gonna use a cold oat, a winter hardy oat, and which will act as a companion crop, but also be highly attractive to the deer because perennial clovers are a slow establishing plant. They're not an annual, so they spend the first bit of the energy that they have to put down a root system and get established before they start growing a big top. So the addition of the oats in this particular situation really help in the establishment of the clover, but they also provide some great nutrition and additional biomass while we're waiting for those clovers to really step up and show their full potential next spring. So our anticipation was to be able to provide good food sources and opportunities for places to hunt, hopefully being able to pattern a mature buck in big timber properties where, I mean, you look at a property that's 500-600 acres of nothing but hardwood ridges, and it's really hard to discern a pattern, especially if you're new to the property. So the stage is set with a little bit of pre-planning, some sweat, some work. We've got some simple tools that we've used. We've got seed in the ground. We feel good that we're gonna provide some great nutrition for the deer herd here and the other wildlife that shares this property. And we're also really highly anticipating some fantastic hunts coming up yet this fall.